So let's go ahead and first of all start out talking about combos and how we would set those up. They're actually very easy to do. And we need to use an example. Let's take a look here at our cafe latte item real quick. You notice that when we click the standard item, really the pricing's tied to the modifiers. And so if we're gonna do a combo that's, let's say, a cafe latte and a bagel, we're gonna have to tie the combo to the modifier for the coffee drink and then to the actual standard item for the bagel. So let's look at how that would happen. Click on Manager. We're gonna go to Administrative. And before we actually go to inventory maintenance, what we wanna do here, kinda like we've done with everything else, is it's probably a good idea for us to go ahead and build a department for combos. Those will show up over here on the left-hand side as their own entity, which is good. It'll also help us to keep things sorted and organized a little bit better. Now that we've got a department created, let's go into inventory maintenance. And when we click on the add item button, we're going to have an opportunity here to actually create a combo. It's a type of item that we're going to build. So let's click on that. And we want to make sure that we're putting this item in the combo meals department. And we'll just call this one combo one. That's the item number, and the description is going to be 8 ounce latte and bagel. All right, so obviously one of the big benefits from a marketing standpoint with combos is that you're encouraging the customer to buy more, and you're going to give them a little bit of a discount. So we know that our cafe latte was $2.50, and I believe our bagel was $1.50, so we're looking at $4 there. So if we want to create a better price for those items, we're going to be putting that price here in the override price. So let's go ahead for the moment here and just key in an override price at $3.25. Let's go add the items that we're concerned with. The first thing we're gonna do is add one of our bagels. Now we can do a couple of things here, it's really handy. We could actually add a particular bagel, or if we wanna pick process, we can actually go and add our choice item that is the bagel choice item. And that's gonna allow us to pick from any one of the bagels for this override price. So let's go ahead and select the bagel choice item, and then let's go find our cafe latte. Now keep in mind again, as we mentioned, this is a standard item. There's no price associated. So if we were to tie this into the combo, it's not really going to make a lot of sense, and it's not going to give us. It's actually going to allow us to pick either the 8 ounce or the 12 ounce drink, which might blow our pricing. So we'd probably be best if we actually go find the modifier, the 8 ounce latte, since that's the one that we're actually pricing this combo with, and add that one to the pick list. So these are the items that are in our combo now. And we're gonna go ahead, as with the others, and define any printers that we want this combo to print to. We're gonna show the calculated cost of the items here, and we're gonna show our override price and our tax setup information. And then down here below, it's gonna give us the option on how we wanna handle pricing. So use calculated price is really gonna keep the pricing where it was with the system. And that may not work so well either with a bagel choice item being at $0. So let's use our override pricing, which is really the pricing that we're surely good with. So we're gonna pick those two, and let's click save. And we're not gonna create any more items. In fact, I'm anxious to get back out here and ring up this item and see how it goes. In this case, we're gonna log back out and log back in so that we can see the combo meals department. Now let's click our item. All right, and the first thing it's doing is allowing us to pick from any one of the bagels in the list. And then you can see that it's automatically assigned the 8 ounce cafe latte at no charge, and no additional charge. And we've got a price of $3.25, which was our override price for the items. So if we were to just ring these items up by themselves, 8 ounce latte with no flavor shot, and then any one of the bagels, the price would have been $4. In this case, using the combo meal, we were able to price that at $3.25. So that's pretty much all there is to creating combos. You can see that there's a lot of flexibility here. We can engage a lot of our element types. We can use standard items, modifiers, choice items in the combo. So it gives us a lot of flexibility in the workflow. You can really build whatever you like.